Welcome back, guys, to Neo Racing. This is race three now in round one of our Variety Series Championship. On Project Cars 2, off we go. Team White at the front, Bidster and Blakeney. Blakeney with a cracking start from the first row into the first corner. Looks like Blakeney's going to take the lead into the first corner. And everyone else through, a bit of contact further back. Footman Seek, everyone just continuing together. As we go up to the hairpin at the top end, Stevie, Footman and Seek. Side by side in the background, we'll wait till the camera makes it. There we go. It's going to be three wide into hairpin, I think, at the front. The pack's still close as well. Blakeney and Bidster into the corner, and Stevie runs wide. Footman goes through. Another blue car slow out the corner as well there. I think that was Flapper. But as we go out of that corner, oh, Team Blue make contact. Seat one and flying Flapper on the straight. Incredible stuff as we come down towards the hairpin now. Flying Flapper looking to take sixth place. Seat one going backwards. TY says, I want a bit of this as well. Flapper does exit stage right onto the grass. Footman's off as well. So we'll get some replays on that. Here's a replay of what happened to Footman on that one. Ah, oh, just outbrakes himself. Straight on into the kitty litter. Spins it round and then gets on the power and then up. Well, I thought we were going to do some donuts then for a minute and give us a little show, but no, has to go the wrong way and then turn round and then back on track. As we rejoin, watching Seek there, and then in the background, Cyrex on the inside of Flapper in the background. So everyone else through there, as we've got Team White taking the lead. Blakeney still holding the lead from Bidster, so he's finally got the hang of this car. He's doing very well, this Blakeney now. Very well into the second to last corner. Oh, a bit wide there though, very wide in fact. Bidster closes up, Neil Farmack as well. So after starting from the back, Bidster and Neil are back at the front of the grid, and Bidster's got his teammate to deal with now, Blakeney. But it's race on, it's only round one, race three. So still all to play for as we look a bit further back as Team White go into the first corner. Blakeney runs wide, Bidster's going to go through here. Bidster's going to go through, Neil's going to follow him as well. Neil, look at the run that Neil Farmack's got in second place. As we come down to up to the hairpin now. Bidster on the inside defending from Neil. Neil's slightly ahead, but if we know Bidster, he'll not give up on the brakes. As we go into the corner, and Neil just on the curb doesn't get as much traction. I think Bidster's going to keep it, but I think they're still side. Oh no, they're not side by side. Neil folds. Bidster's going to have to defend now to keep the lead. Bidster moves to the right to defend. Neil looking around the outside, that's not going to work. Got to be careful. The car doesn't go round on him. Blakeney still in third, keeping the pressure on. As we look a bit further back, there's Flying Flapper a bit further back. Nice place. Oh, more contact. Seeks backwards. Cyrex is off the road. So again, we'll get some more replays. Here's a replay of the incident on lap two involving Seat 1 and Cyrex. Let's go on board with Keith on the helmet cam. See, Seat loses it there. Cyrex has nowhere to go. Bang! And Keith gets the fright of his life. Just avoids it, and there's Flapper on the outside. There's a replay on board with Seek. And what happens is he's going to the corner here. You see the back end just start to go. There it goes. Slight tries to catch it, then bang. Then, whoa, he's got Lamborghinis everywhere. And then have to turn back round and get back going. So that was Seek's view. As you see there, Seek joining from that incident there. It's Flying Flapper now. As we look to the other team, blue car. Keith with jam all over the back of him now as well. Cracking third race this, everyone really going for it, all to play for now in this last round. In this last race, sorry. Jam all up the inside of Keith, gets the run, coming up towards the second to last corner. I would imagine Keith will have to fold here. Oh, I'm so wrong, because he keeps going for it round the outside. Says, no you don't, sunshine. Gotta try a bit harder than that. I'm not the easiest person to pass. So as we complete lap two now, onto lap three. Bidster still in the lead from Neil. Still close up front. Jamal and Keith still battling it out for seventh and eighth place. As we go into the first corner, Keith and Jamal both with a good line there, so it doesn't look like anything's going to change anytime soon. As we look a bit further back, Cyrex closing up to these lot as well. So Jamal's still having a look at Keith. Not giving up yet. We'll have a look on the brakes. He's on the brakes, he's on the inside. Got to be careful not to get the car to spin out too much. And Keith's trying to go for the undercut. Cyrex is there as well. Cracking battle this further back. There's Keith still not giving up, holding his ground. Got some more fire in his belly now, he's in Team Black. He's got Neil as his teammate and he's not giving up. Jamal gives him plenty of space. Cyrex is on the inside to take advantage. Chew, a little cheeky move by Cyrex, but it worked. Little dive back up the inside, and now Jamo's got to defend from Cyrex. So it's all happening here. Jamo ran wider, Cyrex on the inside. Jamo holds off though. Keith still keeping tabs on these two, just in case any mistakes are made. Beautiful driving there by all three. As we go round the second to last corner now, Jamo takes out the breaking boards that time, so Jamo's turn to do it. As we look near the front, we've got TY under pressure from Stevie here, third and fourth place. Stevie's gone round first corner. Oh, almost clips Blakeney as he does so. So very close there for that, but everyone gets away well. But now he's got his teammate to deal with, and the battling Cyrex behind him. He's on board with Blakeney coming towards the first corner. So you see Stevie go up on the curb there and then just go around. And then as he rejoins, whoa, we get the fright of his life. So Jamo and Cyrex again side by side up to the next corner. They've left Keith in the dust as they go up to the hairpin. Team Green playing the team game now. Jamo got to cover that inside off to not let Cyrex back through, and he does so. Cyrex has got to go the long way around if he's going to get past Jamo. As we go into the little hairpin at the bottom, Cyrex very late on the brakes, very sideways into the corner. Now Jamo's gone round. Stevie's gone round as well, so Team Green exit stage right to make more contact with each other. Team Green making contact with each other there, so we'll get a replay on all that. Here's an onboard with Keith, looking at the incident in front. So Stevie goes round, and so does Jamo. They both do the same thing, except Stevie a bit worse. And there's the rejoin. Just a bit of contact with the rejoin as well. As we rejoin this battle now, so Keith closer now, because Team Green have slowed each other up, so to speak. So Team Green running in formation. Let's check on the leaders now. So Bidster coming out of the top areas, coming out of the corner at the top with the white car. Neil lights ablaze in the second car. So a bit of a decent gap between all them now. So Bidster pulling out a lead over the curb, using plenty of curb there on the inside. Bidster's natural touring car line. As Jamo now under pressure from Stevie, wanting vengeance up the inside of his teammate into turn one, and gets the move done, but not quite, because Jamo gets a good run. The two battling teammates, just don't think about Red Bull 2009, guys, because that was tragic. As we go into the hairpin at the top, Jamo sealed the deal with that run out of the last corner, so well done to Jamo for getting the run. Stevie now under pressure from Keith as they go down towards the hairpin at the bottom of the hill now. So it looks like they've got a good little gap over Keith now. Keith was not very good traction at the last corner. Let's see if they do this corner proper this time. I think they both get round there okay. The Team Green recovering, and Footman having a really bad race at the back in 11th place. Seat 1 having a few little faux pas as well in 10th. So let's give you a little run through the field then. Here's Bidster when the camera gets to me. Here we go, Bidster on lap 5. In control of this race, 2.5 seconds ahead of TY. TY's second now. Neil's fallen off. Neil's back to fourth, so Neil's gone backwards somewhat. So Neil in fourth place now, with Flying Flapper on the prowl. There he is in the blue Lamborghini behind the black one. There we go, something over the line. So Flying Flapper's got a bit of a job to do now to catch Neil Farmack, as he runs a little bit wide there, but everyone okay. I'm sorry, it's even more wide in the background. Jamo and Stevie, there's two battling Team Green cars, still close together, but to no avail yet. So Jamo's still holding on from Stevie, but Stevie's not giving up the battle for supremacy in Team Green. We go into the hairpin. Stevie later on the brake. Careful not to touch your teammate, and Stevie goes round. Camera's gone haywire, but Stevie, I can tell you, has gone round somewhere around here. There he is rejoining. So will Keith be able to take advantage? Yes. So Stevie not enjoying this Lamborghini Huracan by the look of it, the Super Trofeo Lamborghini Huracan. I personally think it's a beautiful car, but not a lot of people like it for the handling characteristics, but still a good car in my eyes. So Stevie behind Keith now. Keith got an extra place out of that, so let's see if Keith can hold on. Meanwhile, Neil's back up to third because TY's gone right back. TY, something's happened to TY. There he is. Oh, we'll have to get a replay on that. Here's a replay of what happened to TY to make him go right back down the field. So we're going up on lap 6, up to the hairpin at the top. Back end just goes completely round on him, and then, oh, nowhere to go. And then he's on the infield there waiting. We'll wait for a gap to rejoin. They go through everyone else, Flying Flapper as well. And there goes Cyrex. There goes Jammo and Stevie trying to join TY as well. Keith. Seek. And then Footman. He has to wait all that time and then is able to rejoin. But after TY's demise, Blakeney now to second place again. Team White 1-2. Good pace here by Blakeney. It's good to see him up this end of the field. It's been a long time in the waiting, but it's happening. So he's running with the big boys now. He's got Neil and Flapper behind him. So Neil Farmack closing in on Blakeney now. As Blakeney gets a bad run out of that corner, just commentator cursed him. As Neil looks like he's got a much better run out of there. He'll have a bit more top end as it comes to the hairpin. Blakeney's got to think about defending here. He's not moving over. Neil's going to go up the inside by the look of it. Neil up the inside into the hairpin. Will he get the car stopped? No, he won't. Blakeney says, thank you very much. I'll take that back. As Blakeney now hard on the defence. He's learned after the approach to the previous corner. Lap 7 out of 10. As we go down to the hairpin at the bottom of the hill. Blakeney, Neil only just got the car stopped there. And Blakeney runs wide. Blakeney's left himself open for attack here. Neil's going to look up the inside into the next corner. Neil on the inside. Blakeney gets through. Flapper's wanting to pick up any spoils. As they all go through, Flapper out now, right on the back of Blakeney now. Neil will want to really make a gap in this now. Flapper all over the back of Blakeney, so Team White not with the 1-2 anymore. But Vince is still 10 seconds ahead now because of these battling lot. He was about 3 seconds ahead, now he's about 9 because they've all been battling. So here we are. Oh, and a mistake from Flapper in the background. Almost, I thought he was running the pitch for a minute. But no, little mistake with the car, that's all, but I think he recovered that okay. He's got Cyrex on his tail now, but I'm sure Blakeney won't want to give up on Neil for the battle for second place. He'll want that Team White 1-2. Again, the back end of the car just slides out. That's why the car went to the inside, and now he's got to watch out for Flapper, who's coming up with a very good run. Here comes Flapper. He might even get it done before the corner at this rate because of the difference in traction at that corner. But Blakeney's not giving up on the inside. Still not giving up. Gets the car stopped. And gets on the power. Good move there by Blakeney. He's now flapping with Cyrex all over the back of him. So I've got to watch out for Cyrex here. Blakeney into the corner. There's Flying Flapper with Cyrex behind. There he is. Cyrex from an independent in this. Flapper for Team Blue wanted to try and get a few more points on the board because it's not looking like they're going to have a very strong finish. A couple of finishes here, but hopefully they'll be better off next time. As we go around the long left-hander, around this little right kink up the hill towards this penultimate corner. Meanwhile, TY is not at the back anymore. Footman's gone back to last place again, unfortunately. TY back up to 10th. We've lost Lilian from this because his internet connection wasn't very good and he didn't want to compromise anyone's race, so very sporting of him not to do so. So hopefully we'll see Lilian back out next time. As we now lap 9 out of 10, 2 laps to go. As they go through the first corner, everyone else with a good clean line through there last time. Sarek still running wide out of that corner though. Just got to keep an eye out for that. Jammo coming back in 6th place now. So Jammo's back on the move after making a few errors earlier on. Into the hairpin. There goes Neil Blakeney, Flapper, Cyrex, Jammo. Close as that. So look at Jammo now, closing up to the back of Cyrex. Still a 4-car train. Anything could happen in these last couple laps though. Let's have a little look further back. Here's Keith. with TY closing up to the back of him, so Keith going a little bit backwards there, but he's still keeping with Stevie though. So just them two dropping off the pace of Jammo, so TY looks like he might be able to grab ninth place, but we'll go back to that in a little while as we go back to this battle for fourth and battle for third place. Because Blakeney is ahead, but then this is the battle for fourth. Flapper versus Cyrex, and it'll probably be versus Jammo in a little bit as well, because Jammo's closing up. Ooh, he's going very wide out that corner though. As we come up to the penultimate corner. Cyrex still looking for a way through. Can't find a way through yet. Very hard to, you've got to really set up the move at Red Bull Ring. You've got to keep behind, set up, get a good run out of a corner, and then rely on the run up the hill to get a run into one of the hairpins. So we're on the last lap now. Beers Bidster on his last lap, 11 seconds ahead, controlling this race after quite a bad second race for him. And oh, as he slides the car, oh, a little bit over exuberant there by Bidster, but gets around the corner okay. As we've seen Neil come through now, and then we've got Blakeney in the background, followed by Flapper, Cyrex, and Jammo. We'll just keep an eye on this as they come into the hairpin. See if there's any. Oh, Jammo very late on the brakes, goes very wide there. And I think he's going to rejoin just a bit further behind. We'll see from this camera angle. Yes, look, he's dropped right off. There he is. So Jammo's going to be, looks like he's going to be sixth now, because he's not close enough to make a move yet. But Cyrex right behind Flapper still, waiting for any mistake, just to be patient. Oh, a little bit of a slide there. So Cyrex doing very well in his first appearance in Neo Racing. So it's good to have him here. As we see Neil there. Neil's dropping back though. Neil's dropping back into the cutters of Blakeney here. So he's got to be careful. As we come up to the last few corners now. Got to be careful not to do anything drastic. As Bidster comes out of the last corner. He flashes lights, weaves left to right. He's won the third race. Well done to Bidster. Good race from him. As Neil comes down to the last corner now with Blakeney right behind, not giving up until the last second. And as they come out of that corner, and Neil's going to be second, and it's a Team White podium. And then it's going to be Flapper in fourth, Cyrex in fifth, Jammo will be sixth. Seek one, good recovery up to seventh place. Stevie's gone backwards, wherever he is around here. There he is. Stevie's gone back a bit further backwards in that. So unlucky for Stevie there. There's Keith, he's going to be ninth. Footman is going to be 10th. And TY's gone backwards again. So unlucky for TY. It's a dreadful first race for Team Red. So unlucky for TY. So he's going to be 11th. But there's your winner, Bidster. So Team White victorious. And then we'll see you next time, guys. Take care.